Hi everybody, this is Shanna, design team member for creativesoupforthesoul.ing.com. Today I'm going to come bring you a flower tutorial. Move all my flowers. I'm going to move around here. Hopefully you all know that Trish has a whole bunch of new flowers in the shop. And they're petals. And they come in multiple packages. You can get them. This is the black and gray one. This is a variety pack. I mean, here's some green ones. So, bunch of petals. And here I have taken the petals and made them into 3D flowers. And you can do it with all different shapes. I mean, here's one of the smaller ones. Look how dimensional that is. So I'm going to show you how to make a couple of these. So here's even a little one. And then you can layer them if you don't want them so big and tall. That one I've. So I'm going to move these guys. Put that mat back down. So you just need, I have a glue gun here and some petals, and let's start with this one. There's numerous videos out there, so I don't claim to be the first in this. I'm gonna have one that's bottom, and then I'm gonna take the back side, put a little bit of glue back there and fold it in half, and then take and just a little glue, fold it into a quarter, kind of poof the petals out a little bit so they're not, because you just want glue on the bottom part. And then, of course, the glue string, stick to your fingers. And I'm going to do that with at least four of the petals. Now, you can do this two ways. You can do it with four, or you can do it with five. If you want to put a center in the middle, you can do it with four. But if you want it to be completely 3D, then you can put one in, you can put another petal in the middle. So I'm gonna show you both here. So there is my, and now I've sprayed all of these with some homemade mist to make them all pearly. I just did the whole package at once, so that way I didn't have to worry about it, because I wasn't gonna add any extra color. I love these polka dots. I think they're so cute. So now that we have all of those made, I'm making a circle on my bottom flower there, and I'm just going to layer four of them. I'm sure I need video here. Do I need to zoom down a little bit? There we go. So when you have four of them down, you can either, here I've got like a button. You can put a button in the middle. I've made some flower centers, so you could put a flower center in the middle. I have just some centers. So I'm gonna actually take this last piece, and I actually like to, if I can, with my scissors, I like to cut the tip off, and then I put glue all around the bottom. And then I kind of just put it down in the middle, and I fluff these guys up towards it. I fluff them all around, see? And like I said, I just love these polka dots, and can't see the camera. Now that one is one of the, how many petals that had? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 petals? Yeah, that's got 8, I guess, sides to the petal. So here's a little one, and it's got 6. But you can do the same thing. Like I said, start with the back side. These are just on a smaller scale, so I try not to put as much glue because I really only want it to go in the bottom there. And actually, some of these, sometimes if they're a little like that, you can go ahead and fold them and then just do the inside. But you do want to try to stick to the lower portion so that way, you know, the top petals can poof out, fluff a little bit. Sorry. So I got 4 and 5. So, and the nice thing about these variety packs is that you can get all sorts of colors. I mean, you're in a color scheme, but you get different colors, tones within that color scheme. And so you just put your 4 down. Again, I just kind of clip the bottom edge off that one and pop her in there. Give it a second, I guess, to set, because it's not set yet. And see, that one's perfect for a card. You know, it's not as big, and or a filler. I've used them for fillers. And let's see, this one, I took a skewer and, you know, just kind of play with, I just folded them down this way, and actually you can probably run the skewer clear across and do 2 sides at once. So I did that. I think I did that to like 4. And this one too, you can do the same method I just did. You just get a different look. It's a little bit, it's this particular one, but I did the same thing I just showed you. Okay, so I did 4 of those, and then if you just, I just stick a little piece of glue in the middle, and then well, I put that on very good. I wanted that in between the petals. Another piece of glue, and I just like the look of 4 of them, but you can stop at 3, you can stop at 2. It just all depends on how thick you want it. So see that one, and then let's see, I think I'm going to put this with the red just right there in the middle. And see, I just sat and did a bunch of these up at one time, so then that way, you know, when you need a flower, you've got one made. You can take little ones the same way. This one's a small one. It's already actually curved, so you don't really have to curve it. I just kind of stagger. Actually, I kind of went closer to the edge so that I had a little bit more stagger. And then I just kind of take my finger around and fluff it, kind of pull them apart a little bit, kind of get them how you want. And then you can take anything you have for bling, plop a dab of glue there in the middle, and boom. Flower. time. So those are the two major, just can, you know, layer them. You can do the little petals like this. You can, you know, same way, fold them, fold some up if you want. You can use anything. I've got some big, these were some, I think, Recollection. These are ones I made. You know, you can use your half pearls. I got great big bling. I've used my little rhinestones from my leftover. This is my little leftover mesh bling. I got some crocheted flowers. So, let me show you again. You know, there's lots of possibilities with these flowers to make anything for cards, layouts, altered things. Just do up a bunch one afternoon and you got them ready. Thanks for joining us. Visit us at Creative Soul for the... Oh, goodness, I can't speak. CreativeSoupForTheSoul.ing.com. Thank you.